All right, hello guys. Today we're going to be talking about when you can expect your first frost this fall and winter season for all sorts of areas. This is kind of going in that series of first freeze, first snowfall, and when to expect your peak fall foliage. We're going to be doing it in the same style as that. But before I get started with this video, though, I would ask that you do subscribe if you do like weather-related content. And also make sure to check out the links in the description for our social medias, particularly the Instagram, which we've been advertising a lot because it does have a lot of cool exclusive content that you can't really find on the YouTube. So that's going to be in the pinned comment for you guys to check out. Now, first things first, we're looking at our map where we're going to go over the averages of when you usually expect your first frost. Now, starting off things at the very top, we're starting with late August. So this is already like long gone, obviously. I just wanted to show this because this is when areas, because if I said, you know, September, people would be like, well, we saw it in August. So I just wanted to go over all the actual months and everything. So late August, you can see there is some mountains in Oregon, a lot of those Rockies, the higher elevations in Montana, Idaho, Wyoming, Utah, and Colorado alike basically all see their first frost within the month of August, particularly in the later half of that month. Now, moving on to our next slide here, you can see this is when we expect to see it in earlier September in these pink regions. There is some regions in Maine up there you can see that are in this, and then also northern interior Minnesota as well, portions of California, Nevada, Oregon, and then also the Rockies. I wanted to mention that a lot of areas in interior New England did see their frost a bit earlier because we have been seeing below average temperatures for most of New England, but especially those inland areas. So a lot of those areas in the White Mountains, Green Mountains, and Adirondacks, I'm sure have already seen their first frost. If anybody lives up there, you can correct me if I'm wrong, but I'm sure that you guys actually saw it in the first half of September, most likely. So that's because we did have colder than normal conditions for quite a while. I think we're dealing with colder than normal conditions right now for you guys, actually. A lot of people on the East Coast have been cooler yesterday and today, which is really cool to see a little bit of a cool down going on. We saw the NAO and AO go negative a couple days ago, so that's why. Now, again, all these pink areas for Montana, Idaho, Wyoming, Utah, Colorado, all these areas are expecting their first frost for earlier in September. Now we're adding another region. This is the late September region, and it's kind of like a magenta color, kind of pinkish purple here. Now, this extends into a lot more areas. Again, in New England, you can extend that a little bit further south because of how cold things have been and expand it a little bit further. Probably the areas that are shown right here for late September, most of these areas have probably already seen their frost by earlier in September. So we've been dealing with a lot of colder conditions out there. Now, a lot of areas, again, in California, mountains of Washington getting involved now, Rockies, and we're starting to get some of those northern plains involved with this late September region as well. Some regions of Michigan and then Arizona and New Mexico as well, starting to see some of their first frosts coming up very, very soon in the later September time frame. Now we're going to add one more region, early October in this light blue. Now we're starting to take over a big chunk of the United States. Most of the northeastern interior United States, as well as some coastal regions in Maine and a little bit of areas just north of Boston there, seeing their first frost by early October. Chicago's in this, a lot of Iowa, Nebraska as well. All of the Rockies already obviously are taking over, and most of those four corner states as well, northern half of Nevada. So we're seeing a lot of areas have their first frost by earlier in October. We should have, you know, a lot of the United States by this point. And when I say early October, by the way, it's before the 15th on average. Now, late October for a lot of these darker blue regions. So, northern Texas, northern Oklahoma starting to show up, almost all of New Mexico by this point. A lot of the northern Gulf states have seen their first frost by this point, by later in October. Some nights are going to get close to freezing, so this is why we start to see at least a couple nights go pretty cold by this point. But Kentucky, Tennessee, and some of those mountains down there, on the border, the Smoky Mountains, basically, beautiful, beautiful area. If you live nearby and can visit, always visit that area during the fall. It is absolutely wonderful, particularly Gatlinburg, lots of awesome places. And especially if you love country music, it's such an awesome area. I could go on and on about that area. I love it there so much. Now, D.C., New York City, and Boston, you're all in the late October region as well. Now we're going to move on another one to the early November area, and this is going to be in the dark green shade. So you can see a lot of regions in Texas, just north of Dallas. We will count Dallas as being in there for early November, probably around November 15th for you guys. A lot of the regions in North Carolina, South Carolina, Georgia, a lot of these Gulf and South Central and Southeast states being involved in the early November timeframe for your first frost. Eastern Virginia, that's where I'm from, early November. We usually see it, you know, before the 10th, I would say, of November, as we're on the northern range of that. But again, a lot of areas are going to see their first frost in early November that are in this green region. Now, we do have a light kind of lime green region. Now, this is the November 15th or later region. If you're outside of this area, on average, you don't really see a frost a lot of the time. It is possible that you do, but a lot of the time, you do not really see a frost throughout the year. But in this light green shade, we do see areas, again, they do see their frost is just after November 15th. So a lot of coastal Georgia. Another area I'm going to shout out is Jekyll Island down there in Georgia. That is a beautiful place as well. Absolutely awesome beaches. Just a beautiful, beautiful area. As well as Charleston, South Carolina. That's another beautiful area that I've been to as well. We do see the panhandle of Florida in this, as well as some of the areas like coastal Alabama, coastal Mississippi, and as well as areas in coastal Texas, which are receiving a lot of flooding right now, and a lot of areas in the northwestern regions of California as well. Now, we're going to go ahead and move on to your anomalies. So this is going to be more like, comparatively to what we just saw, are you going to see it sooner or later than normal? Now, we're going to start off with your later than normal. Basically, I guess you could say west of the Rockies, we're going to see it later than normal. Throughout September, throughout October, we are expecting to see, you know, warmer than average temperatures start to become more prominent for this area. I know that we do have a negative PNA right now, which is giving you guys some colder than normal conditions. So a lot of the mountains and areas that do expect their frost in earlier September and into mid-September are seeing their frost probably a bit earlier. But besides that, it does look to warm up if the PNA goes positive. So I am going to go with a little bit later than normal for these regions out there west of the Rockies. I think the Rockies will have it about average, though. Now, sooner than normal for a lot of these areas in the northeastern United States, northern Gulf states. Again, New England has already seen their first frost earlier than normal, so that's pretty obvious that they're going to see it sooner than normal. But areas near the Great Lakes and as well as the north central United States, like the Dakotas and Minnesota, Iowa, Wisconsin, all of these areas are most likely going to see it pretty much sooner than normal. Now, the reason for this is I'm going to show you my September forecast and my fall forecast. This a little bit of a disclaimer with the September forecast. What we've seen basically be off, and there's always a little bit of inaccuracy with this, is we've seen below average temperatures for the most part for the northern range of that below average region. The southern range, like Oklahoma, Kansas, Colorado, Missouri, we haven't seen it quite as much as we were expecting. And as well as in the average for New England, we have been seeing below average temperatures. So you could probably extend that blue to over there. And for the past five or so days in the west, we've been seeing colder than normal conditions. So it's going to be a little bit closer to average than initially predicted. But for the most part, this is how earlier in September went from the 1st through the 10th. This is about how it went. Now, for our fall forecast, which is going to be a little bit more relevant, we do see above average temperatures right along the coast. We do have, you know, the PDO is positive, and I know a lot of you don't even know what that means, but basically things are leaning towards warmer than average conditions for the west coast right there. And then a southeast ridge is looking quite possible there for the southeastern United States. And we do have below normal conditions expected from just east of the Rockies down through Oklahoma and then back up through the Gulf states, the Great Lakes states throughout the rest of fall. So this is basically October and November. And we do see an area of moderate blue there for the north central United States. So the Dakotas, Minnesota, Iowa, Nebraska, and Wisconsin alike. We're expecting even further below average temperatures as we start to see those cold blasts head into the area further into the month of October and November. Anyway, guys, I hope you really enjoyed this video. If you have any more suggestions for videos like this one you'd like me to make, I'd be happy to do that for you guys. On slow days where there's not much to talk about, I do like to make videos like this just because this can be said at any point. You know, I could talk about when to expect your average frost. I guess it would have to happen this month, but for a slow day, this is a perfect video to make sure I keep my, you know, daily upload streak alive. I have to have something to upload about, so sometimes I make videos like this. Anyway, guys, again, suggestions, go ahead and leave them in the comments. But besides that, I hope you enjoyed the video, and I hope to see you guys in the next one. Have a great day, and have a great September and fall time.